see. If you'll just have a seat on the examination table, I'll do a quick checkup and administer your vaccine dose.
I wasn't done looking around.
There you are. You should notice a decrease in symptoms within the hour.
Awesome.
Thank you, Doctor.
Oh, Miss Wellard?
Don't leave.
Yes?
I swore an oath to do no harm and heal the sick, so I would never turn away someone seeking vaccine. But I'd like to offer you a suggestion. When sneaking around other people's houses, don't stand so close to the windows.
Oops.
I'm sure you're aware of the consequences if you were ever caught.
Huh?
Understood.
Oh, he's a nice guy. Won't give us up. So, wait a second. I did not look around the rest of that place. I do not approve.
Yes?
I think. Yeah, never mind.
Never mind.
Uh-huh.
I'm just worried.
Have you been?
No.
I guess.
I can't. What am I?
At least.
Miss Well. Oh, any.
Okay, I'm gonna look around everything else first, and I'll grab the stuff here. Bookshelf.
That is a heck of a lot of books. Nice to know the doctor's well read, at least. They're mostly medical textbooks. Nothing that interests me.
A bust.
A cross section of a human head. Odd, but kind of fascinating. I'm no doctor. I wouldn't know what to do with it.
Okay, microscope?
I remember having one of those when I was a kid. Too bad it broke. There's nothing on it to examine. I guess this must be an experiment of some kind. I shouldn't touch it. Who knows what's in there?
Wash basin?
Must be where the doctor washes his hands.
Not over there?
I'd really rather not.
A skeletal hand.
Why would he keep a skeleton arm in a jar? I'm not getting near that thing.
Anatomy chart.
None of this makes any sense to me. Bodies aren't exactly my area of expertise. None of this makes any... I can't make heads or tails of this one. I can't make... I guess that's supposed to be a drawing of a brain? I guess...
So, if I look at the examining table now...
Doesn't look very comfortable.
Crutches.
I wonder who those are for. I don't need them. I should probably wait until the doctor gets here before I sit on the table.
Okay. So it's as soon as we get the stuff from here and then we look at the table. Right, so you could miss descriptions, but there's nothing else to pick up that I can see.
It says... No. She's pretty. The doc... This jar looks like it...
Just want to make sure she...
Well...
Looks at everything.
Well, maybe just... I'll just have one. That's enough candy for now. This jar is full... I don't... I've seen one of these before. I think that... It's nice to see the doc... I just had a That's the fan... There aren't any mess... Huh. There... I don't need... I guess you can't... No, I think that... Impressed? I don't think... There's lots of... That's probably... The doctor will know...
Okay.
I should probably wait until... Doesn't look very comfortable.
Good afternoon.
Skip
Hello,
to this.
Doctor.
I've...
Yes.
You...
Yes.
You must just...
I
see. If you'll...
I wonder if she really did look familiar to him,
there
but he couldn't place
you
it until now.
You should notice a decrease in...
Thank you.
Oh, Miss Wellard?
Yes?
But I'm sure...
Understood. She obviously doesn't want to be bothered. He's not much of a conversationalist.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, may I help you?
I need to schedule a follow-up appointment.
I was told to schedule a follow-up appointment.
Of course. Let me just show you our calendar, and you can pick a date that works best for you.
Is that today?
It says vaccination, Karen Schmidt.
Oh, wait. Was this today? Oh, the weekends are scribbled out.
Today's date. It says house call, Silas Harrison.
All right, right. Today's November 9th.
It says house call, Jerome Bromley. And underneath, surgery, Derek Cooper. Appendix.
Do we know a Cooper?
It says house call, Jerome Bromley. It says staff meeting all day. This date is blank. It says surgery, Paul Scott, medulla oblongata. This date is blank. It says vaccination, Anthony Prescott.
Do we need to know any of these?
It says vaccination, Dora Everly. It says lunch with Nero.
Oh, Nero. Heard of him.
This date is blank. How about this date?
Perfect. I'll pencil you in. All set? See you soon, Miss Wellard.
Isn't that too soon? Wasn't it supposed to be like four... a month later? I don't know if I'll be messing anything up.
Yes, may I help you?
I was...
Of course.
November 30th.
How about this date?
Perfect. I'll pencil you in. All set? See you soon, Miss Wellard.
I don't know if we can get later than that. Alright, so... off to central storage, then.
Welcome to the Ministry of...
Central storage.
One moment, please. Error. Password required. I'm sorry. Do you require...
How do I put in the password?
Central...
One... Error. I'm sorry. Do you...
Wait.
Nothing else. Thanks.
Thank you for using this.
Next week's surgery. Oh! I thought the password was actually next week's surgery. You know, like three words you have to input. It's the date.
Yes, may I help you?
Could I change my appointment date?
Is it possible to change my appointment date?
Sure, that won't be a problem. Take a look at the calendar and let me know which date works best for you.
Okay, so next week's... So we're here.
It says surgery, Paul.
So that's 16.
It says vaccination.
That's just a vaccination.
It says vaccine.
And that's a vaccination. So it's November 16th. Oh, that's the year, 2072. I don't know if you saw that. Okay, so I'm going to write this down. 11-16-2072 or 72, or it just might be 11-17.
How about this date?
Perfect. I'll pencil you in. All set? See you soon, Miss Wellard.
It didn't actually change the date. But where can you input the password?
Welcome to...
Oh, the password isn't a numerical. Medulla oblongata. What kind of surgery? Okay.
Medulla oblongata?
Password accepted. One moment, please. Central storage is located to the left of the administrative cafeteria. It is the unmarked door next to the cleaning closet. Do you require further directions?
Nothing else. Thanks.
Thank you for using this directory. Have a pleasant day.
I don't even know, because this will just bring us right there anyway. Ooh. Look at that. There's a terminal, an alarm, metal door, a chute.
I remember seeing a diagram of one of those in a book Nelson had. When the alarm is triggered, the little clapper hits the bell and makes a noise.
Mm-hmm.
There's not much I can do to it with my bare hands.
Smoke detector.
Interesting. I guess they put this in here as a part of the emergency detection system. I don't think tampering with the smoke detector is going to help me here. Besides, I can't reach it.
A wire.
Looks as though the terminal is connected to that alarm bell via this wire. Pulling on the wire might trigger the alarm.
I'll get to that last.
This must be where the crates wind up going. I wonder what's on the other side of the wall.
Me too.
I don't think this chute will open manually.
A trolley. There's something on it too.
I'm guessing this is what they use to transport the crates around. Looks like someone left a box cutter on it.
Ooh, a box cutter.
Well, if someone was careless enough to leave this box cutter here, we'll just go with the old finder's keeper's rule.
Yoink.
As tempting as it is to go trolley surfing, I should focus on the task at hand.
Trolley surfing.
A standard box cutter. The blade is pretty sharp. I'd best be careful handling this.
Mm-hmm.
That is one huge metal door. There has to be something fairly important on the other side. But what? I don't think opening this door is going to be quite that simple.
I'll cut it with my box cutter.
I don't see how I can use that there. That goes back out into the main hallway of the ministry. Well now, that's certainly tempting.
Please select your function. Open storage door, system maintenance, emergency override. Version 1.3. Verification code. No emergency detected in building systems. I don't suppose it's also the date of the surgery. No, it's a 5-digit code, apparently. Just seeing they're both 5-digit codes. Yeah.
This must be where the crates wind up going. I don't see how it. I wrote down what it said on the doctor's notepad. This week's CS password equals next week's surgery. This section of wire runs from the alarm out into the hallway. I guess it connects to the rest of the alarm system.
So that's the password to tell you where to get to it. Now you think the people that work here would, even though this place is twisty-turny, they would know where to go anyway. They wouldn't need a password to tell them where to go. So maybe the password is the date of the surgery, but it's a 5-digit code. It's 11-16-2072.
The ticket is for this week's vaccine lottery.
Well, maybe we can cut the wire with the, let's see first. episode 10. Cut the wire with the box cutter. Can't be that easy, right?
Well, now if the alarm goes off, the alert will at least be limited to this room.
Okay. Can you cut this one too?
If I cut this wire, I don't know if the terminal will affect anything in the room.
Oh. What if I cut the wire up here?
I can't reach this wire, but I don't think I should cut it anyway.
Alright then. Well, at least we accomplished that. Now I just gotta find out where... what kind of five-digit code... Maybe the receptionist, the mole, will be able to help with that?
Astro Brand Simply Porons. Astro Brand Simply Poron stains, scrub, and watch them vanish. Warning, do not use on silver, painted surfaces. I don't see how I can use that there.
Huh.
I don't think that will have much of an effect on the alarm.
And then the floor cleaner?
Achilles has no weaknesses when it comes...
Muffle the alarm?
There. That should muffle the alarm if it goes off.
Ha ha ha. I like it.
Hopefully with the rag stuffed between the clapper and the bell, the alarm will be muffled if it goes off.
Seems like we are going to make it go off. But... we still need to open the door regardless.
Astro Brand Simply Pour on stains, scrub, and watch them vanish. Warning, do not use...
I'm surprised I can't look at the vent.
Good idea. But I don't think the pistol will work on its own. I'll need to start a bigger fire.
Well, this thing is...
Achilles has no weaknesses when it comes...
flammable.
I'm not sure how I can use those things together.
It's flammable.
The pistol is only slightly damaged. Should be useful if I need to light anything on fire.
Like the thing we have. Oh, never mind.
Astro Simply Porum.
So maybe we can light the form, the blank form?
I'm not sure how I can use those things together. I wrote down what it's this week.
I don't have any ammo.
My trust. It's out of.
So that is out. Maybe we'll put the brochure in here?
Something tells me this brochure will be more useful in here.
What if we need even more? Can we put this in here too?
I've already got enough paper in the bucket.
Okay. And then we can light it?
The paper will burn, but slowly. It needs a little something more.
It needs...
Achilles has no weaknesses when it comes...
This is the Achilles? This is the Achilles.
Okay, let's get some of this cleaner in the bucket.
Okay. So I guess we can have it.
My cast iron bucket. It's got some incredibly flammable material in it. I should be careful.
Light it up.
I should put this thing down somewhere before trying to light it.
Alright. Where do you want to put it?
I don't see how I can use that there.
On the trolley? Oh, the floor, actually. Oh, we can't look at the floor, but it's a... we can select it when we have the bucket. That's interesting.
This looks like a good spot. My bucket, full of flammable liquid floor cleaner and paper, and in a rather convenient position.
All right. Light it up.
Here goes nothing. That did it. I'll put out the fire before it gets out of control.
What did we do?
I don't think...
Emergency override. Door override engaged for emergency detected. Yay! Vaccines!
Oh my God.
Full of vaccines.
There's enough vaccines stored in here to treat the entire population for years. Danton was right. The government has been lying to everyone all along. This isn't right at all. The people need to know the truth.
Well, I can't do the other thing? Wait. Vaccine horde.
Unbelievable. This could treat the entire population.
Uh-oh.
Amy Wellard, by order of the aristocracy, you are under arrest for trespassing on private property, breaking and entering, theft, and tampering with official Ministry of Medicine documentation.
Oh, that's
all. I'm sure there's been some kind of misunderstanding.
Our orders are quite clear. You are hereby ordered to come with us for detention in Rockwall Prison.
Don't I at least get some kind of trial first?
We're here to escort you to Rockwall, not to answer questions. If you do not cooperate, we have authorization to shoot you on the spot. You are also ordered to return those stolen clothes to their proper location before leaving the ministry.
Fine. Let's go.
Not good. Well.
Wellard, we've got a visitor.
Oh, brother.
Good evening.
Tiberius, you can't let them keep me here.
I'm very sorry, my dear, but things are a bit complicated. I came to explain your position.
Go on, then. I'm listening.
Do you remember the day we were bombed, Miss Wellard? I can recall it quite well.
She was 5.
I was young, but yes, I was in school. I lost a lot of friends that day. My mother, too.
My condolences. You are aware that the reason we were attacked was for control of petroleum and mineral supplies, yes?
What's that got to do with anything?
Sure, but what has that got to do with anything?
Rebuilding our society has not been an easy task. We still have much to do. Of utmost importance is maintaining order. Do you understand this?
Then why are you telling people supplies of vaccine are limited? You could help everyone and work on finding a permanent cure.
Yes, you are correct. And if we were to cure the population and allow our society to thrive once more, what do you suppose would happen next?
Happiness? He's trying to get at things would be worse, but I think things would be great.
It would be great. People could live normal lives again, not have to worry about scavenging or dying of the plague.
Oh, of course. And when a rival nation caught wind of that prosperity and decided we had something they wanted? We would be attacked. Experience the horror of war all over again.
Oh, wow.
I would not wish the bombings we experienced on my worst enemy. I cannot let that happen again. I will not. Let it happen again. Do you understand me, Miss Wellard?
So
I'm aware that the current system is not perfect. There is a clear class divide, but we are not tyrants. Aristocracy has always striven to care for the citizens who provide aid, despite their circumstances. In any case, I am genuinely sorry that things had to turn out this way. You did perform your job quite well, perhaps too well.
I was just doing as you asked.
I asked you to infiltrate the rebels and gain their trust. I did warn you that my protection could only go so far. You could easily have come back to me and informed me of Danton's plans to invade the ministry.
She threatened to have me killed if I set foot anywhere near your tower. What was I supposed to do?
Informed one of my guards. Sent along someone you trusted with the information. Though it hardly matters now. I've gotten all the information I need.
But how?
With this.
What's
that? A gold ball on a string?
A clever listening device my soothsayer came up with. It was placed in the handle of your crossbow.
Oh, God.
I have been tracking you in order to ensure I learned the location of Danton's hideout.
Oops.
You've been spying on me this whole time? Why didn't you just tell me you were listening in?
It was a test of loyalty, and unfortunately, you failed. It's truly a pity. I would have loved to give you your payment. You could have continued spying, opened up a mechanic shop, serving the government. Alas, I cannot reward criminal behavior. It would not be looked upon favorably by the public. We would lose the support of citizens like Mr. Harrison.
So what, you're just leaving me in here to rot?
I'm afraid not. Order must be preserved. I find myself forced to tie up loose ends.
He's gonna kill
Danton and her rebels will be eliminated. As for you, it really does pain me to have to do this. But the truth is, I have no choice in the matter. You must be executed.
Hmm.
What? Why?
I understand this is difficult for you. However, my hands are tied. I simply cannot take the risk of keeping you alive.
And what if I promise not to tell anyone about the vaccine horde?
I'm afraid you've proven to me already that I can't trust you. In any case, I wish to thank you for your service. I'll make sure your execution is quick and painless.
Wonderful.
Goodbye, Miss Wellard. Again, I am quite sorry.
Oh my God. Oh!
Hmm?
Crow or Raven of Doom? Well, before we check out the weird raven, let's look around. All our stuff is gone. We still have our lottery ticket.
This thing is useless to me now. Looking at it just adds insult to injury.
At least we got our vaccine. Well, if we can escape.
I should get rid of this stupid thing, but maybe it can help me.
What are we doing?
I'm going to need something long and thin if I want to do that.
Okay, we don't have long and thin right now.
Interesting. There's a tiny hole at the bottom of the sphere. Locked up tight. I don't think I'll be getting through there anytime soon. Hey! Anybody out there?
What are you yelling about in there?
Oh, we have all these things to say. Let me out. I'm innocent.
I'm innocent. I shouldn't be in here.
Please. Do you know how many times a day I hear those exact words? It's at least 200 before lunch. So I'll tell you what I tell everyone else. If you were really innocent, you wouldn't be inside that cell right now. So drop it, would you?
Sure about that? Don't I at least get a last meal?
I'm hungry. Haven't you ever heard of a last meal?
Sorry, but we don't have any food for prisoners. Most people in here don't stay long enough to justify having a last meal.
Hmm. I have to go to the bathroom.
I need to go to the bathroom.
So use the toilet in your cell. All you have to do is wave your hand over it and it'll open up.
Huh. Okay. Not that I think they would, but I don't want them to do anything about the bird. And I don't want them telling this, so I might say this stuff after.
Never mind.
A pile of what?
Looks like the previous occupant of this cell left a few things behind.
Something long and thin, maybe?
Most of this stuff is just junk. Hmm, what's this? Huh, looks like the previous occupant at least got a dose of vaccine. Oh well, an empty syringe might be useful in a scrape.
There you go. Now we can open that ball.
If only this had a dose of vaccine in it.
We did just get one. I'm not sure if it would be useful. I mean, I guess we could hold on to it.
Looks like the previous... I don't need anything else from there. It doesn't look particularly comfortable. I guess this cell is designed for short stays.
Hmm.
I'd rather avoid sitting on that thing if I can help it.
A drain.
It's some kind of mechanized drain operating on a motion sensor. I guess that's what passes for a toilet in this place.
Can we fit through there?
It's open. There's some pretty foul-smelling water at the bottom.
Ew.
It's already open, and I'm not using it.
I'm closed. Alright, let's look at the weird bird. Oh, the window. Oh, there's a panel as well.
The window is protected with an electrified mesh. I guess that's one way to keep people from escaping. I am not in the mood to electrocute myself today. The raven looks like it's trying to get in, but the electrified mesh on the window isn't letting it. Weird. Are his eyes red?
Sure are.
What do you want? To come in here? You'd best fly away, bird.
It's the Reaper himself.
This panel seems to have something to do with the electrified window. It hasn't got any buttons or anything I can mess with on it. There is an opening at the bottom, though. It hasn't got any button.
An opening on the bottom. Well, let's try to open this thing.
Poking at the trinket randomly won't do much.
I get to
if only...
Do this.
Let's see if this works. Aha! Interesting. This wire could be helpful, and it makes this thing useless to Tiberius. Seems like a win-win situation.
Cool. Got a wire?
I don't see how I... That won't have any effect on the mesh. A medium length of wire. If worse comes to worse, I could probably just hang myself with it.
Nah. Don't do that.
I don't think that will have any effect on this trinket. I'm not sure how I can use those things together.
Well, we can mess with the panel.
This should fit through the opening at the bottom. There. This panel seems to... It hasn't got any buttons. The wire is live now. I'd better be careful.
Oh, do we de-electrify the window and send the electricity through the wire instead?
The wire is live. I could probably move it with my foot, but I don't know what that would accomplish right now.
Probably nothing.
The window is protected with an electrified... I'm not in the... You're a persistent little guy, aren't you? The raven looks like it's weird.
Alright, well, something else we need to do. What are we supposed to do with the wire?
The wire is live now.
Put it in the drain?
Hope this works.
Okay, short it out. Haha.
What are you doing, little guy?
He opened it?
Well, I wasn't expecting that. What a smart bird.
They're letting us out.
Great. Time to get out of this hellhole.
You have sent the soldiers to the market district?
Yes, Minister Tiberius. They're heading over as we speak.
Excellent. And the spy in the Ministry of Medicine?
Taken care of.
Good.
Oh no!
With regards to Miss Weller's execution, please be sure to tell the firing squad to aim for the head. Don't drag it out.
Yes, Minister Tiberius.
Oh, such unpleasantness. I really take no pleasure in having to do this sort of thing. I just hope it will all be over soon. Good evening to you.
At least he's true to his word on that. Huh. That is pretty interesting. Okay, so we're stuck up here. We need to get out of here without him seeing us. Just seeing where he walks to next. Okay. So we gotta keep an eye on his his route around the place. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and we'll hopefully get out of here. And always, seek adventure.